Good day to you, dear Odooers. Let me ask you a question. What's better than closing a deal and selling something once? Well, obviously, to close a deal and get recurring revenue. The subscription business model is becoming more and more popular. In the past, we knew it mostly for magazine subscriptions or distribution services, but nowadays it's pretty much everywhere as all kinds of products and services tend to be sold as subscriptions. Music, cleaning services, food, consumable products, and software are just a few examples among many. The advantages are huge. First, it can be nice for our customers if we offer a lower monthly price rather than a larger amount that they need to pay up front. For us, unless the customer decides to end the subscription, the income keeps coming in automatically and indefinitely, keeping our cash flow going strong. A subscription creates a strong link of trust between the customer and the company. That's why at Stealthy Wood, we're looking into the idea of renting furniture using a subscription model. However, for now, let's see how we can manage our online magazine subscription with our Odoo database. All right, so here I am on my database. Let's go to the subscriptions application, configuration, subscription templates. All right, I've already created two. So I have my monthly template and my yearly template for my online magazine. If you would like to create one, you simply have to click on the create button. But let's go ahead and see how I've configured my monthly template. So I'm going to click here and then go to edit mode, so that we see all of the options. So the first thing we need to do, of course, is to add or to give our template a name. Okay, so I've called this online magazine subscription monthly. Pretty straightforward. All right, and then we're going to have our invoice period right below that. So I've said every month. We can change this to days, weeks, or years, and we can also change the amount here. So I could say, for example, every 6 months. I'm going to leave it as one. And then we also have a duration. So we can say that this will go on forever until it's manually closed, or it could be for a fixed amount of time. And once I click on this, I'm going to have an additional field where I can specify the amount of time, but I'm going to leave this as forever. Then we have several options for the payment mode. Okay, so I have manual, draft invoice, and try to charge the customer. So that's the option I've selected. And also invoice only on successful payment. So something I want to point out here is with invoice and try to charge and also invoice, we're going to have an additional field, invoice email template. All right, for the email template, I've chosen subscription invoice send by email. But if you choose some of the other options, such as manual, draft invoice, or invoice only on successful payment, you're not going to have that field. Okay, so if you have selected one of these other options, don't freak out. That field is only available for invoice and try to charge. On the right side, we're going to have some options for the customer portal. So first of all, we're going to be able to say if we would like the customer to be able to close the subscription. All right, so I have this checked because I do want to give my customers that option. All right. And then underneath that, we're going to have the automatic closing limit. So when it comes to the subscription needing to be paid for again, it will go into the renewal stage. All right, if my customer does not pay for the subscription or does not pay for that month's invoice, then the subscription will automatically close after 15 days, and we can change this amount here, the amount of days here as well. All right, then we can add the group of subscription, the journal, and deferred revenue type. So here we can add a revenue type model as we've learned about together in an accounting video. So for example, yearly subscription revenue can be acknowledged on a monthly basis, meaning that a single payment valid for a full year of services is expensed by month from an accounting point of view. All right. Below, we're going to be able to add our terms and conditions for the subscription. All right, so I've already added my terms and conditions, as you can see right here. And then the next tab over, we're going to have our health check. All right, and we'll be able to modify these rules. So we have a lot of options on the subscription template. I like how I've configured this, so I'm going to go ahead and save this. And then I'm going to go to subscriptions, subscription products. All right, I have created one for this template. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click on this. So the first thing I did here, and let's go into edit mode so we can see everything, was select can be sold because it can be sold. And I deselected can be purchased. All right, for product type, I said it's a service because subscription products do need to be selected as a service here. Okay, I changed the buy price, also added an internal reference. And if we go to the sales tab, underneath the subscription section, I made sure that the option subscription product is selected. Okay, if you create the subscription product from the subscriptions application, this will be selected by default. However, if you do create the product from another application, it will not. So just keep that in mind. And then I've added the subscription template here as well. Okay, so the one we just looked at, the online magazine subscription monthly. All right, let's go ahead and save this and then create a quotation. All right, so we're going to go to the sales application and then create. Let's choose our customer, Fantasio Motors. Then I'm going to go ahead and add the product. Okay, so Midnight Wood online subscription. I'm going to save and send this by email. Okay, send. Now, once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and preview it to see what my customer will see. So I'm going to click on the preview button. All right, so here they have several options. First of all, they can accept and sign for the quotation, which I'm going to do right now. And once they've done that, they'll be able to pay for it. All right, so we're going to click on pay now. This will be by wire transfer. Let's pay and confirm. Okay, looks good. And now we're going to go back to sales and check out that quotation. And we're going to confirm it. We're going to say that, yes, we received the payment. We received the wire transfer. So we're going to go ahead and confirm this. Now, once we do that, turning it into a sales order, a subscription will automatically be created, all right, which is really convenient. So let's go ahead and check that out right now. All right, so we have the subscription. It's in progress, all right, since we confirmed that sales order. And let's go ahead and click on edit and say that this needs to be renewed. Okay, so I'm going to click on this little box here. Okay, I'm going to check this. So the to renew button or checkbox here is an indicator that the subscription needs to be renewed. It's automatically ticked when a payment fails. All right, so this indicator also appears on the customer portal. So let's check that out right now. I'm going to click on save, and then I'm going to go to online preview right here. So again, we're seeing what the customer will see. And we see to renew at the top right corner. All right, they'll be able to change their payment method if they need to, and they can even close the subscription from their portal. All right, so that's an option that we activated from the subscription template. All right, so let's go ahead and close the subscription. Okay, subscription is too expensive. I'll just say sorry, can't do it. And then confirm. All right, so as the customer, I just closed the subscription. Let's go back. If I need to, I can also send another message here in the history saying, hi, sorry about that. All right, send. Of course, since I am logged in, I'm the admin, the message will be sent from me and not the customer, not Fantasio. Let's go back. We're going to be able to see the history, everything we need to see from the subscription chatter. All right, so first of all, it's closed. That happened automatically because the customer clicked on that button from their portal. All right, we're going to scroll down to the chatter. We're going to see that it's been closed. We're going to see the closing text, okay? And we're also going to have that message that was sent from the history. All right, and I can also send a message from here as well saying, it's okay, send. And the customer will be able to see that in the same place on their portal in the history. All right, so let's go ahead and look at that right now. So I'm going to go to online preview again. And in the history, I see it's okay. So as you can see, it's really convenient for both you and the customer. And the customer will feel like they definitely have some control over what's happening with the subscription. All right, so there's definitely some mutual trust going on here. Now that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.